The Philippine Environment Department asks Congress for more support for its national greening program. The project seeks to plant trees in 11,000 hectares of vulnerable areas, such as watersheds and deforested lands. This comes shortly after President Marcos Jr. urged authorities to include tree planting as part of their long-term flood control strategies following the devastation of severe tropical storm Paeng.
Ating 2023 proposal ay sa pangalatan ng DNR ay about 23 billion. Pero sa National Greening Program, nabigyan po tayo ng mga 2.5 billion to implement ng ating National Greening Program. So for 2023, kung malibigay po ito at nalilinan natin sa Kongreso, at ilalaban po din natin sa Senado, kung mabigyan po tayo siguro, marami po tayong matatanim sa next year.
The Philippine Disaster Management Agency reports dozens of additional deaths due to severe tropical storm Paeng. The death toll now at 150, while 36 more are still missing. The estimated damage to agriculture and infrastructure also ballooned to over 5 billion pesos. Relief operations continue across the Philippines. The Philippine government has also released over 8 million pesos in cash aid to thousands of storm victims. Some storm-hit areas are still feeling the effects of Paeng. In the province of Laguna in Central Luzon, many villages are still inundated while other areas are covered with mud. Here in San Pedro City, residents use boats to move around. Clearing operations are also ongoing to remove trash and thick mud. Over in Batangas City, several roads serving the village of Talahib Pandayan were damaged. But residents say the bigger problem is the lack of water supply. Occidental Mindoro also reeling from Paeng, with its agriculture sector losing some 311 million pesos in high-value crops. Local fishermen also appealing for help after strong waves destroyed more than 80 fishing boats.
Mabigyan sana inputs ng mga tulong financial ng mga binhi ulit yung aming mga magsasaka para makabangon naman. Sa National Food Authority, sir, may request din tayo na kung maaari sana bilhin nila yung mga storm damage palays kasi ang dami naming storm damage palays.
For a top Philippine health official, the responsibility of keeping workers safe amid relaxed mask rules lies with employers. Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergeres says it's up to business owners and companies to decide on mask protocols in their workplace. The health official also reminds the public to always assess the risks in deciding whether to mask up.
Sa mga may-ari ng kumpanya, responsibilidad po natin ang ating mga empleyado. So kailangan, kayo rin po, kayo ang magsasabi kung ang inyo pong kumpanya o yung place of work ng inyong mga kasamang empleyado would be appropriate na magtatanggal sila ng mask voluntarily. Ating kumpanya, mas makakabuti na ang kanilang empleyado ay makapagmaskara. Maari naman po natin magbigyan ng ganitong rekomendasyon or advice.